I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I quickly show you the products from the new Tonic Studios craft kit. There's a paper pad, and love that, especially the satin mirror card is yummy. The specialty papers with the gorgeous texture, dies, lots of them, the big word dies and stamp sentiments you can combine. And here are the words and the mats I cut to show you. And the smooth precision glue pen, a glitter marker and a tape runner. And some gorgeous gemstones and very pretty vintage drops that dry matte. Word of warning, I do go crazy with the drops in this and the next video. They add such a fun texture to a project. I start with gluing a word and a mat together using tacky glue, and I do this the same way for all the words. And then I let it dry under something heavy like an acrylic block. If you would prefer a quick review, please let me know, I can do so next time. I just wanted to make a few card examples to show you and make sure the video didn't get too long. In this video I want to show you some card examples I made with acetate this time. I used sturdy acetate from package material, just some recycling. And I'm sorry for the reflection of the light that comes with the acetate and the mirror card. And I start with a card base with a little extra strip to tape the acetate to. Here I tape it to the inside, and later on in this video I will show you another way. I have cut two circles and I cut those in half, and I'm going to tape them to the card. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you, and if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. I add a piece of painter's tape to make a helpline for adding the circle parts. I like the inside pretty too, so I will add two circles to the inside of the card, and you can skip this part. Now I add the word with tape, and you can use the tape runner too, of course. I also add a strip to the outside and to the inside. There's just too much white on the outside, and if you have seen my videos before and with the sound turned on, then you may have heard me say that I'm no good with white, and well, it happened again. I use the glue pen to add the gemstones, just a drop, then put the gemstones on and let it dry. and I used a big bottle of vintage drops in the same color that comes in the kit for a fun accent. The card was just a bit too serious for me. The drops take a bit longer to dry on acetate than on paper. Just put the card aside so you don't drop anything on it for 24 hours and that should be enough. This is what it looks like after drying. Some more circles for the next card. I add them to the front and the back again for a nice finish. And I use a sentiment to measure where I need to add the circles. By the way, if you feel inspired, I always love to see your make, so don't forget to tag me at Gerry's Craft Room when you share your work on social media. And here I add the circles to the back for a nice finish. I use glitter drops this time in two colors. The holiday cheer goes well with the dark purple cardstock, and the pink is a fun, happy color. And this is what it looks like after drying. I also added a strip at the top and on the inside of this card for a nice finish. And for the next card I added my guideline to the acetate and I have two squares cut in half. And here I add a piece of rectangle card to the back. I add the sentiment to the front of the card. And I cut some small squares I add on both sides. And I finish with some gems. cut a white card to size with a bigger strip on top and the same size strip for the bottom. I'm going to tape the acetate on top of the card. And then I add the white strip at the bottom. And to finish, I add a purple strip on top, so it looks nice on both sides again. And this is the finished card. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And make sure to keep on crafting!